Welcome back to the 2-Minute Warning. Today I'm taking a look at the Minnesota Vikings and going over them after they signed Harrison Smith, starting safety for the Vikings, to a 4-year, $64 million extension. Pretty big deal for Harrison Smith. But before we get into that topic, just a quick question for those of you who I don't hear from the Vikings fans or just a general fan. Where do you rank Harrison Smith among safeties? Do you think he's the best? Top 3, top 5? You don't got to give me an exact ranking of 4 or 7, but just give me a little range of where you got him. Getting straight into it though, Harrison Smith, 32 years old, getting a 4-year, $64 million deal, signing him all the way to 36, heading on to 37. It's a pretty steep deal, I'm not going to lie. But what this really tells me, my biggest takeaway from this, is that the Vikings are saying, we want to win now. We are not going into rebuild mode after this season, no matter what. We want to keep our star guys to win now. You know, they restructured with Danielle Hunter early on. They're hoping to pay O'Neal later on. Eric Kendricks is going to be healthy. Anthony Barr is going to be with Eric Kendricks. They signed Pat Pete, got Xavier Woods, Bashaud Breeland, Dalvin Thomason, brought back Sheldon Richardson, Michael Pierce, Patrick Jones in the draft, Chad Surratt in the draft. Jay Jettis is on the come up. You can't afford, you know, sooner or later, if Jay Jettis keeps up this pace, he's going to be a $25 million receiver. So they want to get their big ticket players paid now while they can and keep their cheap players cheap while now they can. And they want to win now while they can afford everyone they can. Kirk Cousins isn't cheap. Adam Thielen, Irv Smith, like I said, O'Neal, Christian Darrisaw is going to help improve the offensive line, hopefully. Dalvin Cook in the backfield. This is telling me the Vikings want to win now, which is a good thing. And I do think this Vikings team can win now. And I think in order for that to happen, they need a Harrison Smith. They need the hitman. They need him to help out Pat Pete, who's also up there in age, who might be, I don't want to say falling off, but is more so at a stagnant pace in his career rather than the come up, if you guys know what I mean. He's not 24-year-old prime Pat Pete by any means. But I think in Mike Zimmer's defense, in a defense where he has a lot of guys to count on, you know, his front seven is going to take a lot of the pressure off of him. Danielle Hunter getting to the quarterback, that could cause some questionable throws to be put up in the air. And Pat Pete's going to be in some good coverage spots. I'm excited to see this Vikings team. I'm excited to see Hitman be on this team, back in a Vikings defense that I truly believe in could be a top 10 defense. With the upside, I'm not saying they are a top 5 defense today, but I think these are one of the small, sneaky teams that have that type of upside if a lot of these new guys can, you know, show the guy cast under the tank. Can Harrison Smith show he's still top 3, top 5 safety? Can Pat Pete show he's still top 10 corner? Can Danielle Hunter, eclipse 15 sacks? Can Dalvin Thomason, Sheldon Richardson, Michael Pierce help get to be just a run-stopping defense? You know, there's a lot of big boys to crowd the box. Can Patrick Jones on the other side help create some pass rusher? Just a lot of these new guys, the rookies, the guys that are coming back from injury, the guy that is a veteran but is new to the defense, such as Patrick Peterson. These are the question marks. These are the variables that's really going to determine how good of a defense they are. You know, if only a couple pan out, one or two of these guys pan out, they might be a top 12 defense. If three of the four pan out, they might be top 10. If all guys are big hits, big swings, and all pan out, like I said, this has the potential to be a top 5 defense, and it wouldn't be possible without Harrison Smith. So I'm glad they got him locked up, and I'm glad they're realizing this next 2 to 3 years is a pretty decent Super Bowl window for the Vikings. You know, they got the roster. They're not really going to be looking for a huge trade or a big free agent move. They got what they really need. The only thing that could really benefit them is A, having a healthy year, B, having a better O-line, and C, if you wanted to get really quirky, Kirk Cousins trade, looking for an Aaron Rodgers that's going to be leaving Green Bay. I doubt those two would work it out. And Deshaun Watson, I don't expect that to happen. I don't think it needs to happen. I like Kirk Cousins. I think he's a top 12, top 13 quarterback. I think he could get the job done when he's throwing the ball to Justin Jefferson, Adam Thielen, and hopefully up-and-coming Irv Smith Jr. They got D.D. Westbrook. They got Chad Beebe on the depth chart as some 3 and 4 options. That's a spectacular 3 and 4 option as well. But they also got Dalvin Cook, the workhorse. That, again, that was if you're being quirky, but the Vikings realized they have the team. They got a quarterback that could get the job done. They have a fantastic run game. They have an improving offensive line. They have a great receiving core, probably a top 3, top 2 receiving duo. You know, Adam Thielen, Jay Jettis. I feel like the only other duo off the top of my head, I'm sure there's probably someone I'm missing, but the one that trumps them right now is probably Julio Jones, AJ Brown. Diggs and Cole Beasley's pretty good, but I'd probably take Jay Jettis and Adam Thielen. I'm sure there's another wide receiver duo out there I'm not thinking of. But in the secondary, Pat Pete, if he could be a top 10 corner again, and Harrison Smith can stay a top 5 safety, that's a pretty good duo in itself. You know, there's not many of those in the league. You know, Steelers got a good one because Minka Fitzpatrick probably top three safety, but Joe Hayden, he's definitely not a top 10 corner. Ravens got a good one. Marlon Humphrey, Marcus Peters, that's two cornerbacks, but those are arguably both top 10. There's some great tandems out there in the secondaries, but either way, the Vikings, they got their set as well. They could compete with anyone as well. I think we're going to see a lot of action come from this Vikings team. They're honestly my dark horse Super Bowl team out of the NFC. In dark horse, I mean, not an obvious pick. You know, the Bucs, they're no dark horse team, but I feel like outside of the Bucs, Rams, Packers, Seahawks, Niners, any team outside of that kind of is a steep dark horse pick that many people wouldn't expect, and the Vikings are my NFC dark horse pick. I don't really see any that it can make an argument. Maybe Arizona, maybe, but Vikings is it for me. I like to sign him. I think it could be a little risky in 3 years when he's 35 going on 36 and he's getting $16 million a year, but Harrison Smith has done right by the Vikings his entire career. He's been loyal to him. He provided a lot for him, and they're doing right by him now. Like, giving him maybe a little too much money when the time comes in 2-3 years when he's on that 34, 35, big over-the-hill slump or hump, whatever you want to call it. We'll just see how he is at the end to define it then. But either way, I'm glad he got his money. I'm glad the Vikings are realizing we got to keep this guy and we got to win now. We got the roster. It's just a matter of putting all the pieces together in the right time. They need to be in the right place in the right time, and that's kind of unfortunately a bad thing for the Vikings. And even if they don't win it this year or make a run this year, if they got the same roster next year, Aaron Rodgers leaves Green Bay, he goes to Denver, and now in the NFC, you're really just fighting Tom Brady, who at some point's got to fall off the cliff, a Russell Wilson, a Rams. Will still be a tough conference, of course, but just saying, their problems could be a little bit easier if Aaron Rodgers leaves next year. But again, this year, I still got hopes for him. I'm glad they signed him. We'll see how the money pans out in 2 to 3 years, but as of right now, I think it was a good move. But referring back to the question today, where do you rank Harrison Smith? To me, he's probably right around the realm of top five. Some guys I would definitely have in my tier one. Minka, I really do like when he's healthy, Derwin James. It's really hard. He's had such a small sample size, but I do think he's special. Harrison Smith would be in there. Jamal Adams would be in there. There's probably a couple I'm thinking. Jesse Bates, that's a big one. Those are probably my top five, roughly top six. You know, there's probably someone I'm thinking. Justin Simmons, you could argue. Tyrann Mathieu, you could argue. But I think top five, I'd roughly have, if I'm not missing anyone big off the top of my head, in no order specifically, Minka, Harrison Smith, Jesse Bates, Derwin James, Jamal Adams, with possibly Justin Simmons in there, with Tyrann Mathieu sitting in there. You know, I haven't made my list, but off the top of my head, I'd probably put Harrison Smith in my top five safeties. You guys tell me what you think, though. As always, I'm of course, thank you for watching. 2 in the morning.